Now we had the third program. To read three numbers and find the biggest. This also we did by using the conditional operator. But once we do this program by using the if, you will understand that how easy the if is. Okay, let's see. Same input, because we have to input the value from the keyboard using the scanner class. So we have to give import java.util.star. Class name, what is that? Biggest only we have to find out. So I gave a class name related to the program. We have three numbers, int a, comma, b, comma, c. And we have to calculate and store the biggest one. Give a variable name, big. Assume that we are giving a, b, c with the three different values. Don't think that when we give equal values, what will happen? We can do everything, but we have to go through the simple logics first. Then we will develop our logic in a better way. So don't worry, we assume that all the three numbers are totally different. Yes, void main. Scanner class. Afterwards, give the message for the inputting. SOPLN enter A, B, C. In single message you can give, or we can write multiple statements. And we will do this type by using different statements, because there can be a doubt in the mind of the students. Can't we write by using different statements? So this time I will write using different statements. Okay, so enter A. We have A is equal to SSC dot next int. Again give the message SOPLN enter B. B is equal to SSC dot next int. Next one, SOPLN enter C. We will give C is equal to SSC dot next int. Okay, this is only to avoid your doubts, because children may have the doubts, why can't we write three different statements? So in order to answer that, I have wrote in three different statements. Okay, next we see the comparison. I gave you one example using the fingers, you remember. Assume the first number as A, second number as B, third number as C. Same thing I will use. If first number A is greater than B, see here A is greater than B, as well as A is greater than C. A is greater than C, you can see. The middle finger is greater than the third one. So A is greater than B, as well as A is greater than C. No doubt you can see that middle finger is the biggest. So we give in that case SOPLN. What is that? A is big. This is okay. But we wanted to store it in a variable. We use the variable name. What will you give? We will give big is equal to the value of A. I think it is clear. Comparing first variable with the other two, and if it is found as the biggest, we will consider that as the biggest, because all three variables are having different values. Alright, next. Take this case. Middle finger is B, A, B, C. Which one is bigger? Middle finger, no doubt. So A greater than B, if this condition became false, either this statement or this statement becomes false, this statement will not execute, you know, because of the AND operator. We studied this AND operator earlier. in order to execute AND operator, or in order to give the AND operator with a true answer, all the conditions have to be true. If any one of them is not true, that part will not give a true result. That we saw already. So A greater than B is getting false, you just imagine. Then we have to consider that B is the bigger, because I told you all three variables are different. Okay, which is B, the middle one. It is greater than, the first condition is not true, so the bigger one so far is B. Else, we will check if the B is greater than C. A is not greater than B means B is greater than. And now we have to confirm it, that it is the biggest one. So we compare it with the third number, B greater than C. Yes, yes. In our current example it is yes. So we say yes of A and all. We will keep bigger is equal to B. Understood now? Because first condition A greater than B was false, that means B is bigger. Now we compare this B with the third one. B greater than C or not? Yes. So the B is made as the big. Take another example. A, B, C. A greater than B, condition became false. And B greater than C, this is a C, middle finger is C. That is also false. So obviously you can see which is the biggest one. The C is the biggest one. A greater than B condition, what it gave is false. This B greater than the C condition is false. Definitely C will be the biggest. So we will say else bigger is equal to C. Else closed. The main is closed. Sorry, before this we have to give the display. So what we have to give? You may give the statement. S O P L N. Big is plus the contents of the big. This is the message. Big is, and the contents of the big variable. It can be A, it can be B, or it can be the C. Depending upon these conditions, the value will be printed. After printing, close the main and close the class. After this, close the main and close the class. Let us see with the help of values. 10, 8, 2. A is 10, B is 8 and C is 2. 10 greater than 8 and 10 is, and 10 is greater than 2 condition is true. 10 is made as the big. Other parts will not execute, because in the if else statement, if one statement is true, other statements will be ignored. Finally, 10 will be displayed. We give 10, 18 and 2. 10 greater than 18 condition is false, so that the rest of the part will not be checked at all. We will come to the statement, this one. 10 greater than, the C is still 2. Sorry, not 10. The 18 greater than 2. Condition is true, so that the 18 is made as the big. Else part will not execute. Final answer will be 80. Take another example. 10, 18 and 22. Okay. 10 greater than 18 condition is false. Coming to the second line. the 18 is greater than the C. C is 22. That is also false. So what is the possibility? C is the biggest. What was C? 22. 22 goes to the big. Printing it. Finishing. I hope it is very clear. Try all these programs without looking into the copy and then execute it. I would like to give you two homeworks. Write a program to input a character and print whether it is a capital letter, small letter, digit, or a space. So we have to input a character from the keyboard, then check whether it is capital letter, small letter, digit, or a space. One question. Second question is, we have to input a character and then change its case. If it is an uppercase letter, we have to print the lowercase. If it is a lowercase letter, we have to print it as uppercase. Okay, so write a program to input a character, a single alphabet, and then convert it into capital letter, convert the capital to lower and the lower to capital. Okay, try to solve these two, and if you are able to solve, well and good. If not able to solve, we will see in the next class. Thank you.